in Sanger, and he's going to share with you what's going on in Sanger and whatever else we need to talk about. Okay, thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure and an honor to be here today, and I want to tell everybody Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
So this originally started with, I was supposed to give a speech on my vision for the city of Sanger, and then I got a call saying, no, it's the direction, and what updates can you give us? And I said, oh, okay. And staff hadn't gotten back to me. So unfortunately for the pandemic, we're kind of still having the same things in the pipeline. We've had a lot of turnaround inside staff. So our economic director, Tom Navarro, has left us and taken a different position. So we're trying to play catch up there. So that trickles down into the building department. Our finance director also left. He took another position too as well. So we're kind of scrambling right now after coming back from a year of the pandemic. We're holding together pretty good, but we do have some good things in the pipeline, such as the annexation that has been in the process. And government moves slow as it is, so that is a slow process in itself. We are currently doing enhanced infrastructure facility districts. And so what that is going to do is that's going to be a funding mechanism that's going to give us our infrastructure all the ways to about Academy 180, basically. That's the annexation corridor. The funding allotment there could be about $13 million, and that in itself is a process to create that district. And we've already had, I think, our second meeting on forming a committee for that district to where we will earmark that funding so that way the city can't spend it on any other pet projects. And so that's going to help stimulate the annexation, as well as perhaps maybe a project would spearhead that. It's in our general plan and our master plan, and there's going to be a public hearing sometime soon. I don't know how the coordination is going, back and forth with perhaps LAFCO, but there has to be a public hearing with all the landowners to get that behind us, and then hopefully God's people will be fully annexed. We've got a lot of expectations for that annexation as far as business. It's going to be a great business corridor. At the same time, we are spearheading to try and uplift our downtown. We want to revitalize our downtown. There's a lot of chatter about how to do that. So a lot of council members are actually reaching out to local business men down and women downtown, local owners on how do we do that. And we've even started chatter on bringing back dispatch. We don't know exactly where in the works that is. It's going to be an upfront cost, and that's what we're trying to do is put grants out to hopefully get some monies to start that up, because everybody deserves a safe and peaceful living inside our city limit, and I'm a proponent for bringing back dispatch. And so that pretty much brings us up to speed. Any specific questions I can address? Yes, Christine.
The committee mentioned the corridor. Would that be a public citizen committee?
It's gonna be a committee to the EIFD, the Enhanced Infrastructure Facility District. And we're gonna bond. It's gonna be a committee to allocate how those funds are gonna be spent. And there will be two members from the public on that committee. And there is rules and regulation as to how to select them, and perhaps trades that they might have perhaps gotten out of to be on that committee. So maybe certain requirements. Any other thing? Liz?
Eli, you mentioned you were going to share about your vision for the city of Sanger. I'd like to know, share that. I can't vote because we live outside of the city. But
well, one day if we go north, we should go south.
No, we don't want a farm in the city. But I want to hear. I'd like to hear your vision.
So my vision would be, of course, I hope the annexation to the north doesn't do to us what it did to downtown Fresno, which everybody here at downtown Fresno. And as we have a dilapidated downtown right now, I hate to see that spread even faster. So my goal would be to do an EIFD for downtown, and to where the city would partner with a developer to actually restore the building, the historic buildings that went off, but the other buildings that are dilapidated and pretty much served their purpose. They've been here, geez, 70, 80 years. They've served their purpose. There's some landlords that just don't care about people. So with that enhanced infrastructure facility district, we could pay for the demolition, put all the brand new infrastructure, and a developer could come in and do a build out, one block at a time or two blocks at a time. With that, my vision would be make it Christmas Tree City. We already have Tom Flores Boulevard, so Tom Flores Boulevard would be the same, but it would be echoing and have the presence of Christmas Tree City. We have all commercial storage on the bottom with 2 to 3 story living space on top, so that way we can create commerce within our downtown. And to a developer, that's residual income because of the rent. And when they come in and do things like that, because I've talked to people that have already done developments such as that, there's special funding for low income that they automatically do. So we could create affordable housing for low income there too, but it would be upscale apartments on top and whatnot. So that would be my vision for downtown. And we do it the same way we're annexing north with the EIFD. I also think we should turn our Sanger Park, and I think this would help with the nefarious activity that happens there. Sanger Park is famous for nefarious activity. We should model Casa de Fruta, and we should turn Sanger Park into Casa de Fruta.
Wow.
We have plenty of wineries. We should get a merry-go-round. We should create job creation. We can rent the park out at a low cost to someone who knows, a business person who knows how to do this and does it for a living, and they return split the profits 10% to us, and they upkeep our park. But the win is that we're getting sales tax. We're now a vacation attraction to people going to Kings Canyon National Park. We're creating jobs, and we're on the map. So it's not, you know, recreate the wheels, just copy it. And we're poised for it. We have 3 wineries already locally here. I think if we go even further towards McCall, there's about 2 or 3 more. And we can all have a set up, do booths, events. So I'd like to see our Sanger Park turn into a theme like Casa de Fruta, so we can be a tourist destination. And for the north side with the annexation, I definitely think we should have a rec sports complex. And I think that would be a huge draw, because our kids already, we go to other cities and pay tremendous fees to park and play. We can repeat it and do it here. It's needed every year. The council gets asked, please upgrade our fields because we don't have enough green space.
Would that be like something like Greeley has, that sports complex over there?
Greeley and Nainuba, yeah. And however that would be, whoever's gonna do it, the city would just partner with them. Because we don't own that land, so it gets a little complicated. But when you have a municipal and a private MOU agreement, it can be done. So we need it, the community wants it, and hopefully we're heading in that direction. And I can tell you that since I've been elected, I've been meeting with everyone and anyone who would listen, and people are looking at Sanger, and they say Sanger is a gem. They said, hey, if you'll be fair with us, we will build. So Sanger's on the map, and they're looking at us. Christine.
Your carousel idea is a good one, because Hanford,
yes,
took Visalia's carousel out of Looney Grove.
Oh, wow.
And restored it and put it in their downtown. And one other question, a lot of the towns in the valley have a downtown tax that stays downtown, mm-hmm, to maintain and upgrade and repair their downtown buildings and sidewalks and things like that.
Would
Sanger ever be ready?
I think that's something the downtown committee has visited, and it's, they're talking about it.
Yeah.
Yes, and exactly that extra tax would be for maintaining the downtown.
Is that possible with our?
Oh, it's definitely possible.
With our out-of-town landlords?
Because
I know this is something would come up against all the time.
Well, we just have to get them to the table.
Yeah.
And they're going to get to the table. So it's in the works. So we're on the verge of breakthrough, I can guarantee that. Yes?
You would talk about the Sanger Park, you know, doing stuff like that for it to enter parks and the
Not necessarily, so there has to be some renovations. And yes, that does mean some trees might come down. But progress is progress, and if that's what the community needs and is behind that project, then it shall be done. Ms. Yo?
Yes. I'm sorry, I was just stuck back there in the corner. I'd like to ask really kind of a couple of questions. Number one, we started with some of the murals and things downtown. Okay. Has the city considered looking at the town of Exeter, east of Visalia? Exeter is exactly the same amount of distance from Visalia as we are from Fresno and Columbus. And they have made a wonderful little downtown with a lot of historical murals and things like that. Has that been considered? Because we have some wonderful pictures at the museum that would do it for making a mural.
We do. And God bless Tom Nicholson, because Tom Nicholson is the one who has spearheaded that.
Yes.
And you know what? I've just been supportive, and the council tries to be supportive, because Jesus, it was like pulling teeth for him to get that done. And it's like, what's the deal? Is it beautified Sanger? You know, it's just all of us, councilmen and women, getting together and pushing our town forward, coming to an agreement, not letting blue and red separate us, but we're bipartisan. It's what's best for the community, and we need to get that across to each other, because we have some great murals, and it was Tom Nicholson who was doing all that. And so when we first started, Exeter was mentioned. They have beautiful, I think one of them is a nice train, a train station or something. So we do hope to have more. There is more coming, and I think we're utilizing our planning commission now to help speed that process up. And now that we've got a couple under our belt, it should be more available to get it done. Yeah.
Can I help him with that? On Exeter is kind of a blueprint for the mural project. It was actually the blueprint that Tom Nicholson did use for the whole mural project. So that is exactly what inspired him when we did come together as the Downtown Revitalization Committee. So.
Well, they've got some wonderful things there. There's one it's like a little trompe-l'oeil sort of thing where there's an orange grove, and then you're looking at the mural that kind of runs into it right behind it. It's delightfully done.
If you see like the Vice furniture and then also the one that we have right now in Brailler Square, those were inspired by the Exeter, from him visiting Exeter. So that was what he used when he did present the mural project to the downtown.
Well, if you want pictures from the museum, has some wonderful historical pictures from Sanger that we have that would make beautiful backgrounds for murals. But my second question was, I'm going to age myself seriously here, but there was a time when you could go downtown Sanger and you had bakeries and clothing shops and this, that, and the other thing. And I mean, Clovis was a dump, for crying out loud. Nobody went to Clovis, for heaven's sake. Are we going to look at changing the landscape a little bit of the businesses so that we have a number of different things that are going to keep us here downtown, stores that we can use and shop at on a regular basis?
So I think that goes with my vision, and that might be 2 years away, 3 years away, but I think we all want what you just said. And I was just having that discussion with the Hudsons, and I said, not to put an age on anybody, but I said, well, you guys are my age, my city is way better than it is today. So it's public participation, to be honest, because I'm there. I don't work for City Hall, I work for the public. They're my boss. And if I was gonna win a Super Bowl with that same team that let me get my city into the dire straits that it is today, what does that say? So I'm trying to be polite here, but we need public participation. The ideas are there. The methodology to get us there is there. But people just have to go.
Thank you.
Everybody's trying to keep a roof over the head and put on the table. Regina.
So back in the 80s, I was on the planning commission, and we did a moratorium on buildings going up, especially apartments, to make sure that there was enough open space for children to play of the units that were put up. what I noticed was this this building right here, the health building, was built out to the sidewalk. Is there anything to take into consideration to, in the future going forward, that we don't look like a big city with sidewalk and the building, but that there's greenery? There was supposed to be greenery around new building, new development, like the dentist office right out here across the street.
No, definitely, I agree. It's policy. We do have to put it in a policy. And it might have even been there, but it might have been overlooked. But I agree, and that's come to bite us back with the community saying, hey, we need more soccer fields, we need more softball fields, or at least the fields are on, can we maintain them? So yeah, we do need green space, and that's been echoed to the council multiple times, and we're listening. I actually was able to, I increased our savings amount nearly double, and by doing so, they allowed the council to get $800,000. So we have $800,000 since maybe mid-October that the council has put a list in on projects that we can do, and I wanted it for rec. I wanted to fix a Fellow Park because they had a great softball program, adult and youth. So we can fix that up. And for Rotary Park, to get that going and get some lights at JFK Park, that's a huge, widely used community park. So we still haven't had our to-do list come back to us from staff, because they're busy doing whatever it is that they're doing. But, you know, there's $800,000 from the community to meet their demands of what they ask: soccer fields, softball fields, etc.
I have a question. With all this, we're moving, we're growing, but with that demand, we are going to have to increase public safety. You know, we are big supporters of public safety, and we're not at the level that all the other surrounding communities. How are we as a city looking to compete? Because, you know, I see like our fire and our police, you know, people, like the turnaround is so high because they're moving to other communities. How is Sanger going to compete with that so that we can keep with progress? Because if we're going to grow, we have to keep it safe. And that's how, like, when people come, I'm like, we're a safe community. We're a great community. And that's how I sell our community. That's how I sell Sanger. So, and we're growing. So what is your vision for that? Like,
well, that goes with economics. We increase business, we get more tax dollars, we're able to pay our police department, we're able to grow. Without the other, we can't. We just take from what we're existing, we get less, and that department gets more, but less for the community. So we have to grow economically in order to support a bigger PD, a bigger fire department. It goes hand in hand. And at the end of the day, we have to realize and come to the agreement that we are what we can afford. And every man and woman is going to do what's best for him or her family. And if that means getting a bigger paycheck near the coast somewhere or in a neighboring city, well, good for them. Because in the end of the day, we can only support what we can support, just like every other household. We have our vehicle.
I feel like we're fighting like this never-ending battle. That's
the thing. I thought they hired some more police officers just recently.
Or are we still under staff?
I think some have gotten injured and retired. Yeah, they're just okay. Yeah, and that is a cheap question. But. I saw a hat. Jane?
A few years ago, I attended a city council meeting, and a master plan was presented for infrastructure, street lights, and roads. And I've noticed, my goodness, so some of our roads are really
dilapidated.
Yeah. How are we keeping up with that master plan at all?
We're trying. It is a budgetary issue. We're trying. And again, like I said, public participation. You know, we can do budget amendments to a safe level to where we're not putting the city at harm. All right. Any other questions?
So, I'm just to say, so maybe you can mention to them that how they can chime in right now that the city is doing redistricting, and how they can go to the website, the city website.
Yes.
The timeline. You can tell them the timeline.
The city is partnering with an agency to do the redistricting guidelines for the way councilmen and women are selected, and there is a website which I don't have committed to memory right now, that you can participate. It's actually, I think, connected to the city website. So if you log on to the city website, you can actually draw your own district boundaries on how you'd like to see Sanger divided up, and that's how possibly the districts will be selected, and that's how Councilman will get voted on. And that's happening now. I think we've had two meetings on that as well. One thing that I didn't mention too is, as we know, we're facing with SGMA, which is water issues, and we have to make our retention basis. We are looking to put another well on Greenwood and North, and we are looking at, I believe, two other wells in the annex area of Sports 180 on Academy. So hopefully in another year or two, we won't have such low pressure issues. So we are trying to remedy that, and we did have low pressure issues this year due to one of the booster pumps being out on the storage tank that we had out on Church. So with all this rain, these current months have been sent, hopefully we're going to be in a lot better shape as far as infrastructure next year. Christine?
There's been signs up for a housing development, which it reminded me when you mentioned Greenwood and North, for quite some time, and nothing's happened.
And that's the development we're talking about. That's where I was talking about the well. And they are. They're putting it underground. They're moving ahead at their own speed, at risk. At risk. I guess we're not fast enough for them. So they're saying, we know what we got to do, and they're recording everything. You know, right now they're battling rain, so that always puts a delay in construction. So, but they're actually moving pretty fast. Compared to it has, and I'm sure every developer wants to sell it before he even puts the first pad down. Well, again, I just want to say thank you so much for having me here. Your time is precious, and I appreciate it.